Hey everyone, today we're playing Leap of Fate. To quote its description on Steam, Leap of Fate is a furiously paced cyberpunk roguelite about overcoming your fears and achieving your fate. In a New York City where magic is real, you play as a technomage who must develop unspeakable powers to confront the crucibles of fates. Can you survive the trials? So let's give it a shot, huh?
As long as I can remember, I've had issues with family. My mom got committed to an institution when I was 4. And my dad, who knows? So my grandparents took me in. The whole thing was a shock to them, and they sought refuge in esotericism. They became bitter and distant. At 19, I got accepted at NYU in physics. So I left Montreal as fast as I could and never looked back. I loved sciences. But then I came upon this collection of arcane scriptures at the library. These texts went much deeper than those on my grandparents' bookshelf. I became obsessed, came back day after day. That's when they made contact. The Cabal didn't need a silver tongue to convince. They just showed me. Magic. The stuff of legend. It was real. Soon after, I received my initiate's name, Eon. I was now part of an arcane society. A dream come true, right? Not quite. The Cabal's edicts are strict and dehumanizing. Ascension only occurs as magic replaces the mind, or so they said. I, Gabriel Oxley, started fading away. After 7 years of deprivation and absolute submission, it's a miracle I could still think. One fateful day, I found the last bit of resolve left in me, and I ran for my life.
You could almost say we're playing as a Sith. Now that I escaped, I can focus on finding the Crucibles of Fates somewhere ahead. Just somewhere ahead, like in general, in a city, an open city. All right. Ooh, we're in 4x3. Interesting. It looks very intentional because there's framing around the outside. So maybe there's outside of the frame information that shows up. There we go. Oh, you can dash no matter where you are. So we're doing the dual stick shooter type controls, Geometry Wars or so on. You know, well, of course, you like WASD plus mouse. You know what I mean. The top down shooter. Oh, there they are. It was very much one of these games. Nice little art style. At the very least, everything's clear. You can make out what's going on, which is sometimes a problem for this genre. Thank goodness for the arrows, because you wouldn't be able to tell where to go off camera without them. Here we go. This is a more powerful attack. It seems to explode. I don't see a meter going down anywhere, so I think I can just keep doing that. The dash is satisfying. Anyone around? Alright, I think we just summon enemies for fun. Look, more enemies! Double up! Oh, I can't do that. I'm not allowed to summon them both at once. This seems like it would be a fun opportunity to, like, generate combos or get some sort of multiplier for your reward, if there even is rewards. Getting a little ahead of myself there. But at the moment, the enemies are pretty manageable. The main menu showed three other characters I could have played as, but they're all flipped over upside down, saying that you need to play X number of missions with this character to unlock the next one, and so on.
Greetings, Eon. You have come to this place to undergo the test, as many other ambitious mages before you. Here is a magical tarot deck that can read your soul and make you confront your own fears. Survive, and you could become the most powerful mage in this world. Good luck.
Here we go, we got a structure. collecting cards, huh? In a game that has the words of fate as most of its title? Can't help but think of a certain other game. There's the shuffling. Click on this combat card to enter its magical challenge. Okay, now I'm really thinking of that other game. Which I haven't actually played yet, but I know its premise. Special abilities can be used a number of times per combat. Ooh. That's the dash in my right click. Alright, so now they're limited. That's good to know. So you can only do them 4 times per fight. That is important context that has been changed. Oh! The eyeball guys are enemies now, not just a weird mastermind guy. Maybe he's the guy behind all the challenges, so he's inside all of them? To teleport out of this card, hold this button for 1 second. So I just teleport out of here? And then a new card hops up. Alright. Treasure. I'll do double the fight for double the treasure. Haven't had a reason to worry yet. Can I blow up this radiator? Sure can. Also, radiator's not the word for that. Air conditioning unit, there. Hey guys. What are you guys gonna do, huh? You got any tricks for me? Because I haven't been hit yet. Treasure. We got purple. Okay, that's seems to be an experience. It's showing up under my portrait. That's the only one. Alright. They want to make sure you're absolutely sure about teleporting out. Oh! Is this fork locked off to me? Oh no, it says I need a key to open it. I was wondering if it was locked off because I didn't pick the one on the right. Upgrade card. Spend purple, the mana, to upgrade your skills. Alright. Hello. Passive attack and mobility. Oh, I can't click on the other ones. Mobility? Alright, we have an entire tree here. This is a big tree for a roguelite. Haunting Wind. Shadow walk through enemies to damage them. While this practice is frowned upon by most orders, mind invasion remains a disturbingly popular discipline. Alright. It's my only option at the moment, so we'll go for it. Challenge. At least it moves. The good thing is it moves quickly. You're not constantly waiting for loading screens and stuff. Killing enemies with a shadow walk or glyph generate mana. So you're saying they're specifically the two special abilities I have. So that's my incentive to use the special abilities, is that I get extra reward for it. Did I just mind hack a robot? I think that drone just got killed by me dashing through it. Oh, I got hit. I actually took a hit. Shame on me. That's what I get for trying to spam my, trying to specifically use my special abilities to generate more mana. Oh. Hello. Zoom. Well, that worked really well. I think I beat the objective for sure. Bunch of destroyed vehicles around here. I wonder if I heal at all. That's a health item. Okay. Good to know. The game feels pretty all right so far. Everything controls well. It's running smoothly. We can get a key. Energy cells. Don't know what those do yet. Health. Is that extra health? It only costs 10, so I would suspect it's probably a heal. Let's grab energy cells, I have no idea what they do. I would suspect that the health is... Well, it's 10, let's test it. Nope, that is a healing item, as I suspected. So that was useless to me. Die, books? No? Alright. So yes, when you buy health for 10, that specific... Oh, look, there's still a little health item sitting there. I wonder if I can just go back to it to get it back. Can I also go back to the upgrade store? No, I cannot. So now I can do this with the key. So I suspect that these dungeons would be randomly generated normally, but because this is my first time playing, it's probably structured specifically to make sure that I get introduced to each of these mechanics. Atomic Flash. That's my new ability. Try a new glyph. Well, that's a laser. And for the record, you cannot charge it. It's the same. It doesn't seem to take any amount of different time based on how long I hold down the right trigger. Or right click. But it's a big scary laser, so that's fun. Defeat the Guardian. Face the Guardian, level 1. I got him. Oh, no, I didn't. I don't got him. Oh, he's mad at me. He's dead, though, so it doesn't matter. The laser worked pretty well there. Oh, yeah. Powerful little satisfying attacks.
I was wondering how much longer you'd stay on the run, Neo. You made the right choice coming to the Crucible of Fates.
Alright, we can choose a reward for the boss fight. Fast learner, skill upgrade costs are reduced. Tactician, get an extra charge for your shadow walk and glyph, that'd be nice too. Unstoppable force, your basic attack now pierces through enemies. Oh, that would also be very effective. Huh. Fast learner is often a useful thing to get early on for helping you upgrade yourself, but having my basic attack just flow through an entire group of enemies sounds incredibly useful. Here we go. Oh, look at that. It actually looks different now, too. So now do we shuffle a whole new deck? Level 2 out of 6, the future is now. Whenever I hear about the promises of genetics, prosthetics, or nanotechnology on the news, all I can think of are these goddamn top-secret cybernetic labs. Just the thought sends shivers down my spine. More cards. Alright, let's see how it goes when I just can shoot through a group of enemies all at once. Oh yeah, that is effective actually. But we want to get some experience while we go around too. Oh, I've been slowed by the snakes. Oops. So definite downside of I walked through an acid pit, that's also a bad idea. Definite downside of doing the charged laser ability is that you have to worry about stopping for a moment, which makes you very vulnerable to hits. Let's open the chest. Bit more experience. We're collecting more. We'll have to find our way to an upgrade location now. Not so far. Oh, yeah, we do have the key, though. Might as well just find out what's in here. Hi. Wrath of the Ancient One. Gross. Gross! Ah! It's amusing how fast you can send them out because you can only use 5, so this is not a feasible thing to do. But gross, the sound it makes is just All right, ooh, gift for free stuff in a shop. Let's try our combat though. I'm healthy-ish at the moment. Just trying not to ruin that. Oh, that is a giant electric field. All right, that's a new enemy to worry about. Oh. I totally stood still to launch my lasers at them, forgetting that that's not what I have right now. I am taking a lot of damage. I may just actually die soon. Careful. This guy's being a problem, ain't he? Did I not kill him? Got him. Can I get a heal from you? Nope. No such luck at the moment. These guys are alone at the moment, though. Yeah. I'll go down without too much trouble. I'm only one hit point away from dying, though. I've really messed up this mission. Oh god, they're all in that direction. I chose poorly in that moment. Whoop! Really gotta watch out for that big lightning weapon they have. There we go. I was so focused around dodging projectiles, I need to watch out for dodging that very specific path of that attack. Oh. So does that make... is he invincible in that thing? I'm not sure. I mean, it might just be that it's at the edge of the length of my attack, so it's just not feasible to attack him. Or not. Let's look for heals. I don't see any heals, which is bad for me. Oh hey, we have that gift, unless it disappeared or something. Nope. Let's go right into there. Thank you, sir. Needed that. Pew! It's gross. Just gross. What do they say down here? Unstoppable force? Oh, it's just my current upgrades. Yeah, we have those. Let's upgrade. I could use that. Passive skills. Can I increase my health? Or get like a life leech or something? Skeleton key. Keys are no longer spent when opening a locked chest or card. Ooh. That sounds nice. What's the other one? Nanofiber coating. Next attack that hits you is negated. This effect only occurs once per fight and triggers after the first enemy wave. Let's see. I mean, it's a damage block. Oh, you can only grab one upgrade at a time. Well, that's kind of a bummer. I have all these points saved up at the moment. I guess that's what the shop is for. Interestingly, at the shop, you can just keep buying stuff. A card bycast? Ooh, Guardian Reveal. Just tell you where the enemy is right away, huh? Okay. So earlier, my Cthulhu attack turned into a lightning bolt, so I assume that once I spend all my points, I can use the energy cells up here to replenish them, like extra clips. So that's why they're handy. Guardian Reveal would help you get to the ending faster, but I don't know if that's necessarily the best idea. Definitely grab one of those, at the very least. Oh, there's the Guardian. Well, that would have been pointless, wouldn't it? Going straight to the Guardian might be dangerous, but I'm also kind of not. This says it's neatly. It says it's an easy fight. Maybe the easy fight will give me a health item. I believe that it means easy when there's only one. Oh man, that's a new trick to worry about. Okay. Being very rude. There's a healing item up there. Let's find our way to that and just keep careful for the moment. There we go. Mission accomplished, as long as I don't screw up and lose it now. Don't know if the exploding debris can hurt you. That'd be a nasty surprise. Alright, there should be no chest, I believe, because there was no chest on the top down? Yeah. Oh, so much loot, possibly. But also, maybe death. Let's just go for the Guardian. I have a lot of experience that I'm not even spending right now, so it may not be necessary to go that kind of place right now. Oh my god, there's a lot of them. There's a lot right now in that general direction. Oh, I got hit. That was my bad. But there's a heal, so at least there's that. One down. Just be careful. I don't have any incentive to go fast so far, I don't think. Alright, are you gonna have a guardian inside you? There he is. Found him. Pew! Oh, that's a... Those are... a lot of drones. But I've got my armor. That's the passive I picked up, so that'll deflect the first damage I take in the second wave. Which is now. A lot of drones down at the moment. Oh! So yeah, attacking just now wasted one of my lightning bolts. The hilarious Power Rangers looking lightning bolt power up. Oh, whoa! So it does cost one for each additional shot at this point, I believe. That did not hurt him, did it? I mean, it shouldn't. They're not human. I mean, they don't have minds. Or they shouldn't, I don't think. Can you just stop living, please? It'd be swell. There we go. Give me those heals. Yeah. That was totally wasteful of my lightning bolt. I don't know why I did that. All I had to do was this. Here we go. There's dialogue right there. Do a quick lap just to make sure there's no stuff stashed around here. No? Ooh, so you do change your skills. Yeah, I like the shadow bolt, I think. First glyph you made. Target projectile, fire is in the blow. Let's see, killing blows yield more mana than other glyphs. Ooh, that's actually pretty cool then. Maybe I will stick with this. I found out how to switch that stuff out. What's these? That's just how many waves have triggered so far. Hi.
This place strips people of their humanity and throws them away afterwards. Quite similar to the Cabal, come to think of it.
So we got our upgrade choices again. Mana Runner. Following a shadow walk, your special kills yield a bonus mana and loot for a short period. Tesla's Ball Lightning, a damaging sphere orbits around you. Well, that seems nice, but also, I'm hopefully generally not close enough to enemies for that to be relevant, because I'm trying to run away while shooting at things. Time Walk, after a shadow walk, time slows down for enemies, but not for you. That sounds really useful. And I slow down to help avoid incoming attacks, hopefully. So now we have two of these things flying around here. It said two out of six, so there must be six total. Level 3 out of 6, the true face of magic. Except for the Illuminati, the Cabal is the secret society with the most influence over world events. My sources have proofs of Cabal infiltrators in various governments and organizations. What are their goals, and what are they planning? And our pyramid continues. Hey everyone, ooh, where are we now? Are we in a jewelry store? This seems, oh man. They move fast. Hi. Nice to meet you. Rude. Is this thing jamming my abilities? I think it is. Huh. So those things jam your abilities and those other things just sort of charge at you. What are they? They're just kind of rolling around right now, which is weird, but they look like they're mummies filled with spikes. Which is kind of a horrifying visual. Nope. Wave two. Ho 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 ho! No 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 no. Okay, they didn't hurt me on contact that time. But they do definitely just swarm you, which is immediately worrying. Ah, I didn't take enough damage to get that health. Oh wait, they didn't hurt me immediately because I have my shield, I'm sure. So I think I got hit by them both times and really messed up there. Shop. Let's wait. I might be able to heal at the shop, so let's wait till I take a little damage at the very least, probably. Oh no. Got myself a little stuck there. Hi everyone. Oh man. My lack of skill at this kind of game is starting to show. There's the call of the void. And I've run out of lightning bolts. I was overspending. Oh! Watch out, already spent my shield. It's not bad though. Oh god. It's kind of a handy thing to have around because the initial shock of having everyone spawn all over the screen at once can be dangerous. Choom! That did not really hurt them, did it? Maybe it did and it was just not super noticeable. At first it was one-shotting everyone, so it was really noticeable how effective that skill was. There we go. Alright, it's a good thing I did what I did, because that shot might be my only chance right now. Damage taken, you know? Alright, do you sell heals? Yes, you do. Thank you. Alright, a compass. Summon... What does a compass do? Guess we'll find out. And an upgrade card? Sure. That means I can place an upgrade card myself, if I want to. Why are these three golden? Oh, each level find the hidden clockwork key to unlock a bonus card. So this is how you manually place cards. Don't want to upgrade right now because I spent all of my stuff. So we'll go to the combat place and try not to be super dead afterwards. Oh man, he is all up in my business at the moment. There we go, they're tanky. Oh, do those things self-destruct? There's something to worry about, huh? Oh. Chill, ooh. So when they die, they fire projectiles everywhere. They fire projectiles. Oh. I've got company. Okay, he's down at least. Let's just be very, very careful. Trying to get obliterated by all those attacks. Got one of them with that. Hey guys, oh, nope. Thankfully they can't shoot past the blocks just like I can't. We both have the same handicap of not being able to fire over shoulder level. Buddy. Oh, crap. Well, that was my bad. I apparently chose that moment to disregard the fact that he explodes when he dies. Good job, me. No, there's the Guardian, so that's how you get out of here if you want to. Let's visit the upgrade. I'm sure I can afford- You don't have enough magic to upgrade any skill. Oh. Well, crap. I thought I would by now, because the early upgrades weren't too expensive. Are they getting more expensive over time? Tesla's ball lightning and damaging sphere orbits you. Oh, you could buy that here. So the things I'm getting as rewards are upgrades for my tree that you would otherwise be able to buy. Did not know that. What's the mystery? I thought it might be a separate set of upgrades. An extra health icon! That's exactly what I need. It's my anti-incompetence shield. There's basic combat locations as a challenge, I'm curious about that. To succeed, clear this combat without losing health. Oh no. I'm gonna fail, but I might as well give it a shot, because I'm showing off a game I've never played before. This is my chance to try these things in a shame-free environment, right? Careful. If I get through the first wave, I'll at least have a shield to help me out. There we go. First wave down, now I'll have a shield, which hopefully counts towards the techno damage. That's a lot of stuff on the screen doing damage. Yeah! We got it. I was worried. There's my bonus health. Just got two of them back to back, so we've jumped straight from... We went from 5 to 7. Die, priceless artifacts. Die in hell. Well, we got our health upgrades. Let's just go ahead and accept the Guardian. I imagine this might be a hit for people who like Binding of Isaac. Because it essentially seems to take the progression system from Hand of Fate and mix it with the general gameplay conventions of Binding of Isaac. With a few things of its own, of course. And an art style that is entirely its own, I think. Alright, where's this Guardian? He seems nice. Die. Die, 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 die. Oh man. Oh man. Still got my shield, that's a good sign. This guy's trying to block my abilities. Shame on you. That explosion got my... You gotta watch out for that. He shoots frag... like shrapnel bombs. That's worrying. Oh! Yep, that's bad for me. That is bad for me. Come on. Dodge. There, that's one way to avoid the attack. Oh! Did not account on him also exploding. I really should have. Alright. We're off to a good start, I think.
They used secrets to lure you in. They used their authority to break you. They used you to reach their goals. But now, it's your turn to play.
Alright, our new choices. Knife of Kronos. While time-walking, you are surrounded by a damaging aura. Tesla's ball lightning, that's the orbit, and spontaneous combustion. Set enemies on fire when shadow-walking through them. Well, that sounds like fun. Which is enough reason for me, honestly. Ooh, now it's happening. Oh. Oh, we're on the second floor now. This must be where the difficulty arises. Level 4 out of 6, the beginning. Nightmares. Youth is when your world takes shape. You absorb everything, you see and hear, with no filters. What can you really expect, then, when what surrounds you as a child is a broken and harmful environment? I'm curious, on the start menu it said that the next characters would unlock when you beat like 7 missions? I wonder if a mission is an entire playthrough, or if it's just an individual scenario you click on, or if it's an entire level. It would be weird if it was levels, because then they'd think they would say levels, so maybe they do mean an entire playthrough. Reveal all special cards. You know, let's just do that to test it out. So bam, we know what all of those are now. That's a gift. Upgrade station. I think a shop. I don't even know what that one thing means, and that thing needs to be unlocked. Might as well use the compass to figure out what it does after all. Oh my! I'm being crowded right now and I don't appreciate this. I need some personal space, buddy. No. What is that thing? It has a shield? I think it has a regenerating shield. Oh man, you do not want to get... These little star points are just built to trap you in a corner so that you get ferried into a spot where you can't dodge any attacks. What are they? It's like we're in a weird circus environment. Alright, the game seems to have gotten harder, which is what you'd expect on the second floor. Hi, what are you? What are these? They're tentacle knowledge book things? Do they represent eldritch insanity? When the knowledge of what's going on around you drives you mad? Now we got fog that makes it hard to see around you, which is also one hell of a handicap in this kind of situation. Yep. There we go. Just teleport so they all die. We have no more keys. So that's not happening. Alright. Well, we're out of here. Let's visit that gift to heal up. And what- oh, two keys. Oh, that had no health items in it, huh? Oh well. That's the upgrade station. Might as well head towards that. Cause we know we have a decent amount of experience at the moment, so we should be able to do it. Oh! Explosion got me. There are a lot of hazards to worry about at the moment. Oh. Take it slow. Don't want to run too fast so they never get hit by my projectiles. These little fog monsters. They seem to primarily incentivize that you keep moving, because if you're running around in a big circle around the map, then the little fog monsters won't be able to keep up with you, so they can't obscure you where you're actually trying to fight. Then you can just clean them up afterwards. They'd be good to target first, so that the enemies don't get you along the way. But that doesn't necessarily seem like the easiest thing with the initial busyness of it all. What can I afford? Nothing over here. Knife of Kronos. That's the damaging aura for when you're time walking. Oh right, the time walk is what triggers the moment you travel, so I could be damaging people right after I dash. Mana Runner. Following a shadow walk, your special kills yield a bonus mana. I'm not super concerned about that. I'll go for the Knife of Kronos. That seems nice. What is that? Is that a new power? Oh, that's the key. That's the key that helps you unlock one of the special cards over here. Oh, they took away the card that I unlocked. I did not know that was temporary, so I lost that opportunity. Hi! Oh no. I might die. I might actually die here. Yep, there it goes. Abrupt.
It's too bad you failed the test and died. Now, instead, you'll be part of the Crucible of Fates forever. Time for me to start calling the next candidate.
Oh, one mission completed. So that's what missions are. And that mission was... I don't know. Dashing mission. completion time? Nope. High score, obviously. Different kills. Yeah, I don't see any description of what the mission is, just that I finished it, so there's new reward. So if you complete all of those, is it two? Yeah, two more missions, and you'll, as Aeon, and you'll unlock this character, who is apparently named Big Mo, because this is what you, this character you unlock for beating five missions is them. Then seven missions as Big Mo gets you, as Mukai gives you Red. Whatever those characters are. There's a menu. Can I see? Oh, there's a form access. Controls. So delete the usual delete data if you want to start over the entire progression system. All right. Well, this has been Leap of Fate, another randomly generated permadeath type game with its own little progression system and everything that I'm sure some people will obsess over for hundreds of hours. Thanks for watching, like always, guys, and I'll see you next time. And be sure to check this game out on Steam if you want to find out. That's in the description right down there. If you want to get a copy of the game yourself.